Hi students, how are you? I hope you are fine. Okay. Yeah, today we are going to learn a new chapter from our course book. Okay. The chapter name, The Blue Light. It was taken from The Blue Light, written by Vaikam Muhammad Bashir. Our author Vaikam Muhammad Bashir was born on 1908 and died in 1994. Was a novelist and short story writer from Kerala. He was also a freedom fighter who participated in freedom fighting against the British. His style of writing made him popular with both literary critics and readers. That means the style of writing of Vaikam Muhammad Bashir was much interested by the readers and the literary critics who are criticizing the literary works. And his work has been translated into different languages all over the world, in English and in several languages. He was awarded the Padma Shri. Padma Shri was the most famous award in India, the civilian award in India, in 1982, and is thought to be one of the most successful writers from India. He was very famous as one of the most successful writers from India. At first, we have discussed that this lesson we are learning, it is a short part of the novel, The Blue Light. Okay, yeah. This small part of the novel, Blue Light, explains that he was living in a rental house, and he was writing a novel. The one day when the light was off, he went to light the lamp. So he went to the rooms where his friends are living to collect kerosene oil. And when he collected it and came back, and he just entered to the home, something happened there. It was said that there was a ghost in this rental house, but he didn't believe about the ghost. But that day night, when he came back after collecting kerosene oil, he saw something in his house, this rental house. Okay, yeah. Then I think we can go through the lines of the chapter, as well as we are doing at every chapters. Okay, are you ready? Okay, thank you. Then we have an activity, warm up, just to be warm before starting the chapter. That one, look at this picture. Here is the picture of a house, an old house. Draw some details in the picture so that it looks haunted. Yeah, when we are looking to this house, we can see some haunting things, some following things, that sometimes it is an old house, sometimes there will be a ghost like that. Yeah, remember that using strangely colored light will add it to the spookiness. Yeah. Spookiness means the quality of being frightening, usually in an enjoyable way. That's quality, a status, being frightened. Okay. Yeah, some houses, when we are looking to that houses, the old houses, we will seem like it does the ghost house. This image also seems like to be ghost house. Now also come up with a few noises that are here in your haunted house. Take turns with your classmates to make these noises. Yeah, that one here is asking to make some experiences that we have with the old houses, spookiness situations. Okay, that's only. This is your choice. If you have like an opinion or experience with the ghost houses, then you can write it and you can share with your friends, compare their experience also. You can make a sharing details, that's only. Okay, then we can go through to the introduction of this chapter. Okay, the speaker in this story is a writer. Page number 37. Vaikam Muhammad Bashir was the speaker. He was a writer who has rented an old house. He took a house for rental to pay for living there. On the outskirts of a small town in Kerala. Outskirts means the outer parts of a town or city. Yeah, you know, the boundary of a town or city, outer part. Okay, that place called outskirts. He took a rental house in this outskirts near to the small town in Kerala. The house has no electricity, no power. It's not well looked after. Yeah, it was not cleaned, not looked after, protected or preserved as good one, as or it never cleaned like that. But the speaker finds it a perfect place to write his next novel. But the author, the speaker, he thought that it would be very nice home to write a new novel. He was a writer, yeah. He was a writer. After he moves in, he began to live there. The locals warn him that the people who are living, neighbors, they warned him that there is the house is haunted by a ghost named Bhargavi. Yeah. This house was having presence of a ghost called Bhargavi. The speaker does not take the warning very seriously. He never made that warning. 2.5 months pass. After 2.5 months, and he begins to forget about Bhargavi. He began to forget about that warning of neighbor people. Then one day something happens. Okay, that we are going to understand what happened there. Are you ready? It must have been around 10 o'clock. I had been writing a story since 9. Yeah, I just began to write the story from 9 o'clock. And it had been the 10 o'clock. It was a highly emotional piece. Yeah, I am writing very highly emotional piece of a novel, a story. I was writing feverishly. I was writing the story with very excitedly and a kind of energy. And I understood that the light is going to be dimmer. The light should be stopped within minutes. I picked up the lamp and shook it. I just take it and began to shake. There was no kerosene in that. When I just began to shake, then I understood there is no more kerosene in the lamp. But I did not want to stop writing. All my attention was on the story I was writing. I am very interested to complete this story, so I want to continue to write it. I continued writing as the light got dimmer and dimmer until finally it went out altogether. I began to write again and the light began to be dimmer and dimmer again. At last it stopped. It was gone. The light was gone. Now I needed some kerosene oil. I remembered that I could go to the bank and get some. Yeah, if I am going to bank, I can collect some kerosene. My friends who worked at the bank lived in one portion of the building. Yeah, my friends who are working in the bank, they are living in one side of part of the bank building. I could borrow some kerosene from their stove. They will have stove and they will have kerosene. I can borrow from them. So I picked up the torch and the empty kerosene bottle. Went down of the room and locked the main door. Outside, yeah, I reached the outside. There was misty moonlight. Misty means full of mist, full of fog, very foggy moonlight. Yeah, the situation, the atmosphere was full of fog and the sky was overcast. The sky was covered with gray clouds. It is just going to be rain. I walked fast. When I reached the front of the bank building, I called out my friends. I called their names. Soon, one of them came down and opened a side gate. They opened the gate. We then walked along the side of the building and climbed up the stairs. We just walked to the side of the building and climbed through the steps, staircase. The three of them had been playing cats. They are just playing cats from their room. When I told them I needed some kerosene, one of them laughed and said, when I asked them kerosene, they laughed and said, couldn't you have asked Bhargavi to fetch you some kerosene? Why you didn't ask Bhargavi to fetch, to collect it or to get it and bring the kerosene oil for you? I too laughed, but I didn't say anything. Yeah, when I hear this joke, I also laughed, but I didn't say anything. While one of them was pouring out some kerosene from their stove, it started to rain. Yeah, I gave them the bottle and one of them began to pour the kerosene oil from the stove to this bottle. That time it started to rain. Yeah, the rain began to raining. I will need an umbrella too, I said, because I just came with the bottle and it is raining and I have to go back, so I need an umbrella. You think we own an umbrella? Laughed one of them. They said, are you thinking that we have umbrella here? Stay a while and play cards with us. You can stand here, you can stay here and you can play with us the card. You can go back when the rain stops. Yeah, when it will be stopped, then you can go. Until that, you can play cards with us. And so I sat down to play cards with them, but I couldn't concentrate to this play. My mind was on the story I was writing. I am just completely focused on the story. By the time it stopped raining, when the rain just stopped, it was 1 o'clock. I picked up my torch and the bottle of kerosene. My friends got ready to go to bed. The friends, they are going to bed to sleep. And I took the bottle and began to come back. Good night and thanks, I said, and went down the stairs. I came to the down of the room. They switched off the lights as I reached the road. Yeah, they offered their light and I reached to the road. There was no one on the road and no light. I walked along the deserted road, in the empty road. That means there is no people. The road was very empty because it is 1 o'clock at night. I walked along the deserted road by the light of my torch. I reached my house, opened the door and went in. I entered to my house. I had no reason to think that anything exceptional had happened downstairs. Yeah, there is no need to think that something unexpected, unusual will happen in the downstairs, in the stairs of the house. There is no need to think like that. But I must tell you one thing. I want to say something, that my mind was full of strange sadness. My mind was full of sadness. I don't know why it was. So it's called a strange sadness, for no reason whatsoever. For no reason at all. There is no reason to worry, but I am completely have some lot of sadness. I wanted to weep because of my sadness. I want to cry with sad. I went upstairs, still feeling the deep sadness. I just went to the up, but I have the sadness until now. And then I saw something unusual. Something strange. I will narrate it as my subconscious has recorded. Subconscious, the part of your mind that notices and remembers information when you are not actively trying to do so. When we have no concentration, we have no focusing, then our mind, one of the part from our mind will record the something, that situation, and it will be in our mind later. Okay, here he's saying that I will explain what happened there, which my subconscious, one of the part of my brain, has recorded it. When I had locked the house and gone for the kerosene, The lamp had gone out completely. When I came out, came inside of the house and just want to fill the lamp by kerosene, but it was completely gone because there was no oil in that. The room had been dark, no light is there, yeah? And then it had rained for quite a while. Then suddenly rain began to rain. It was more than 3 hours since I had left the house. I was leaving the house at 11 o'clock and now time is 1 o'clock. Then it is almost more than three hours, but now I could see a light inside the room. I know that when I am going for the kerosene, the lamp was just gone, but now I can see a light in the room. I could see it through the things in the bedroom door. Yeah, I can see that light through the narrow opening or holes of the room. As usual, I took out my key. As it's happening normally, I took the key. Then I focused the beam from my torch on the padlock. Then I focused the beam from my torch. I paid my complete attention. The beam from my torch on the padlock. The ray, the flash of my torch on the lock. Okay. The lock gleamed like silver. Then the lock began to gleam like silver. Should I say the lock smiled in the light? That he asking, when I saw that it was gleaming on the lock, can I say that it was the smile of lock? He's just asking. It is the literature of a literary way of Bashir. I opened the door and went in. I just opened the door of room and went in. Then I saw the whole thing. Then I saw the complete thing. My entire body began to move at what was happening. I don't know what was happening, but my body was began to shake. I didn't tremble with fear. I didn't shock with fear. I just stood there and stunned. I became unconscious. I felt a kind of hot heat go through me and I started to perspire. Yeah, a kind of heat just came to my body and it began to me and I started to perspire and I began to sweat. Having drops in the body when we are just tired and sweat. Okay. The entire room was illuminated with a blue light. The entire room was lit up. The room was full of light with blue light. The light came from the lamp from 2 inches of blue flame. Yeah, this blue light came from the lamp. Which lamp? From 2 inches of blue flame. Yeah, in that lamp there was two inches of blue flame. Okay. I stood there in amazement. I was very shocked and in amazing. So I just stood with amazement. Who had lit the lamp? Who did that? Lit the lamp that had no kerosene. This lamp was no kerosene. Then who did that? Where had the blue light come from? Where from this blue light came? He was asking that. Who did this lightning? And where from this blue light coming from? It is the story. Everything is clear, yeah? I think there will be no doubts on this chapter. Very simple and very little one. Okay? Okay, thank you everybody.